Update report. With us now is a co-sponsor of the Defund ACORN Act. We have California Republican Congressman Ed Royce. Hello, Mr. Royce. Senate voted 83-7, as Steve Handelsman said, to defund ACORN. Will the House follow suit?
You know, I think, Larry, it's going to be a tough vote in the House. For some time, we have been trying to show that ACORN has been committing voter fraud in 14 states. You'll notice here that ACORN was involved here with not just tax law, zoning law, prostitution law, how to get around of all of that. But what I want you to concentrate on for a minute is the role ACORN played back in the lobbying effort against the Federal Reserve when the Federal Reserve wanted to do something about the over-leveraging in Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Mm. ACORN was directly a beneficiary, and they saw that a housing trust fund is a way for them to get money automatically from the government. And so when the feds came to the federal government and said to Congress, we need to take action, they're leveraged 100-to-1. They're frankly a systemic risk to the financial system. It was ACORN that was out there lobbying against this because they were going to be the direct beneficiary. The more risk that the government-sponsored enterprises took, the more profit for ACORN.
So besides pimps and prostitutes and voter registration fraud, they were on the wrong side of the whole housing and Federal Reserve story. I didn't know that part. Let me ask you, I mean, I'm sure a lot of taxpayers are asking. These guys got $53 million, since the middle 90s. Why? What was the purpose of this in the first place? Why should taxpayers finance this left-wing group?
Well, you know, part of the argument was you would be pushing affordable housing. But we know that money is fungible. And at the same time, what these organizations were also doing was constantly carrying out campaigns for rent control, voter registration efforts, which were anything except legitimate, as we find more and more about the fraud. As you know, attorneys generals in so many states have got ongoing investigations on that front. And I want to just have the taxpayer focus on the cost of that bailout of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. That was a $400 billion cost, and one of the most active lobbies here on the Hill was one of the great beneficiaries of Fannie and Freddie. That was ACORN telling members, especially on the Democratic side, and if you remember, Chris Dodd killed that legislation. Chuck Hagel put it out of the Senate, out onto the Senate floor. Chris Dodd killed that legislation that would have allowed a competent regulator, would have allowed the deleveraging of these portfolios when they'd gotten up to $1.5 billion.
With that kind of, I mean, let me just ask you a couple of quick questions. First of all, does ACORN have ties to the Obama White House?
Well, they're a community organizer group, so that's what they do. And those who are trying to fund ACORN are trying to expand community organizing direct action in communities across the United States.
And do they have ties to the liberal leadership of the House? I mean, I'm talking about Ms. Nancy Pelosi, Barney Frank, and others.
Barney Frank has traditionally carried legislation like the Affordable Housing Trust Fund that was intended to benefit and grow ACORN in communities around the United States.
When do you think this House vote to defund will take place?
Leader John Boehner, myself, others that are co-sponsors of this are calling for an investigation. Tomorrow you'll hear more about that, and we're going to try to force a vote on the House floor as soon as possible.
Do you think it'll pass? I mean, I haven't heard the House leadership comment on this yet.
Well, you saw the vote in the Senate. I think the House leadership is trying to keep this from coming to a vote, and my suggestion is that the public should be directly involved. Your wallet's at stake here in terms of the cost of the taxpayers.
Yeah,
of
ACORN. I think taxpayers just baffled why these guys got any money in the first place. Voter registration fraud, now this whole episode with pimps and prostitutes. The point you're making about unaffordable housing pressures on the federal authorities. It's an amazing story, Mr. Royce, but we thank you for coming on the program, sir.
Thank you, Larry.
All right, coming up in the Kudlow Report, President Obama.